Management must carefully monitor and control the inventory of each item. Inventories can become too large due to a business recession or simply because a particular product is not popular among consumers. To reduce the inventories of slow-moving products, it may be necessary to mark down prices, increase advertising, or do both at the same time. Two main concepts for businesses are how quickly is my business moving merchandise and what is my inventory worth. Several measures of the financial performance of a company are based on average inventory. Find average inventory by finding the average or mean of all inventories taken during a specific interval of time, such as a month or a quarter. For business efficiency, it is the average time for merchandise to sell. The number of times that the merchandise sells during a certain period of time is called inventory turnover or stock turnover. This is a measure of how well the company is doing financially. Inventory turnover varies widely from one business to the next. For example, a flower shop must turn inventory over rapidly to avoid the costly waste of wilting flowers. On the other hand, a furniture store will have a lower inventory turnover since furniture often sits in a store before being sold. To determine inventory turnover, we first need to compute the average inventory. And here we have the ratio, total of inventory values, divided by the number of times inventory was taken. Here we have three different dates when the inventory was taken. And to calculate the average inventory, we will add those three values and divide it by three, the number of times the inventory was taken. This gives us the average inventory. For calculating a stock turnover, this refers to the number of times the average inventory is turned over or sold during a period of time. Businesses value inventory either at retail or cost. And because of that, we have two different ways of measuring inventory turnover. Here we have turnover at retail, which is found by taking retail sales divided by average inventory at retail. Here's the inventory at retail. This is the sum of the price tags on everything in the store at three different dates. The sales during this period is given. And the first thing we need to determine is the average inventory at retail. So we take the three values from the inventory of retail, find the average, that's our denominator value, and then find the turnover at retail by taking the retail sales for this period of time divided by the average that we just got to come up with our ratio. And this ratio or turnover value that we got at retail is almost 4, which means this is the number of times that the average inventory is turned over or sold during this period of time. We can also calculate stock turnover at cost. So instead of looking at retail prices, we're looking at cost prices. So here we have four different dates where they determine the inventory on hand using the cost of the inventory. And we're also given the cost of goods sold for the period. We're not interested in their selling price, it's the cost of the goods that were sold. So before we can find our turnover ratio, we need to find the average inventory at cost. So we'll add up the four inventories, divide by four to come up with an average inventory cost. That value is in the denominator. And to find our turnover ratio, we'll take the cost of goods sold during this period divided by the average inventory to give us a turnover ratio of 3.22. So a little over 3 times the average inventory is turned over during this period of time. The turnover ratios are or can be identical by using either method. The variation that often exists is caused by stolen merchandise called inventory shrinkage, or merchandise that has been marked down or has become unsellable. Normally, turnover at retail is slightly lower than turnover at cost. For this reason, many businesses prefer this more conservative figure. Let's take a look at comparing the ratios. When a business has a high turnover ratio, it means that the products get sold fairly quickly. What kind of businesses would have a higher turnover ratio? Those that have perishables, grocery stores or other stores like the flower shops. A low turnover ratio means that the products remain a while before sold. So, we mentioned the businesses might be furniture businesses, could be car dealerships, and so on. The stock turnover is useful for comparison purposes only. Many trade organizations publish such operating statistics to permit businesses to compare their operation with the industry as a whole. In addition to this, management use these rates to compare turnover from period to period and from department to department. It's important for managers to track inventory moving along the supply chain, sitting in warehouses and on the shelves in stores. Only by tracking inventory can they cut down on theft, figure out what is selling and what is not selling, prevent the waste of buildup in unneeded inventory, and more inventory quickly to locations where it's needed. Years ago, managers used periodic inventory systems, which required a physical inventory at specific intervals, such as the end of each quarter. However, today, most firms have moved to perpetual inventory systems, also called continuous inventory systems. These inventory systems continually track the quantity and availability of inventory. A number of technologies have been developed to help track inventory in perpetual inventory systems. One of the first techniques, and one that is still used today, is the Universal Product Code, UPC. This technique requires a tag with black stripes, called a barcode, to be imprinted on each item in inventory. The tag can be scanned at cash registers or other readers. A disadvantage of the UPC technique is the requirement that it be scanned with light rays. As a result, the UPC code has to be visible and directed toward the machine reading the code. You may have watched cashiers as they repeatedly scan an item at the cash register, trying to get the machine to read the code. Many firms use radio frequency identification, RFID chips, which are read using electronic product code or EPC devices. The giant retailer Walmart was one of the first to adopt this technology when it required all suppliers to put RFID chips on pallets and cases by the end of 2006. Although some RFID chips have tiny batteries, most use energy emitted from the machine reading them to respond with an electronic signal. One advantage of the RFID chips is that they do not have to be pointed at the machine reading the information on the chip. Another advantage is that they can be very small and cheap. Scientists have even glued RFID chips on tiny ants to study their movements. RFID chips can also be read quickly, as evidenced by new toll booth technologies, which read the information stored on RFID chips on the windshields of automobiles driving through the booth at 50 miles per hour. In the future, the same RFID chips that allow managers to monitor inventory may be used to electronically provide cooking instructions to a stove or microwave. Amazing, isn't it?